And I actually wanted to do like a quick little two-minute segment today on Stop. So while we're talking about it, I mean, let's do it. So I basically wanted to go over the why use a stop loss. And I see a question in the chat coming up of, you know, I'm in the stock now, should I get out of it? And my answer is you use a stop for it. So the reason, or I guess what a stop loss is, just for anybody who's not aware, is basically you're setting a price for a stock you own. You're setting a price and you say, if the price drops below this price that I'm determining, sell my shares. You're telling your broker to do that. So if the stock's at $10, you can put in a stop at $9. And what you're saying to your broker is, if the stock drops below $9, sell my shares. And the reason why I really recommend using stops, and the reason why I like them, is because it takes emotion out of trading. I think that a lot of people lose, and especially newer traders, they get burned when they're emotional trading, right? So this GMHI that we're talking about, right? Let me pull the chart back up for you. You know, this thing had a massive slide down. You know, if I didn't have my stops in, I could potentially just be holding the bag and watching this thing go all the way back down and below where I bought it at. So the stop helps you to plan your trades ahead of time and take the emotion out of it. And I would say that right now using stops is maybe more important than ever, because we are in an entirely momentum driven market, right? We're seeing moves on a lot of these high flyers like we have never seen before. We used to see these on one specific like industry, like cannabis or 3D printing or cryptocurrency. I mean, these are various ones that have popped up throughout the years. But I mean, we're seeing it on pretty much everything tech right now, where we're getting these crazy momentum driven names. And when the momentum pops, the momentum pops, right? This GMHI, I mean, we saw the stock go from $22 to $14 in a matter of one day, right? Those are crazy type moves. And so the way that I recommend employing stops is essentially, you know, let the momentum carry you, and just keep moving your stop up, right? So if your stock is going from 10 to 11 to 12 to 13 to 14, maybe hang a dollar behind, right? And always have your stop in, keep raising it up where, you know, if you come a dollar off of that high, you're getting out of the stock. If you want to get like a little more tactical with it, the way that I recommend doing it is by looking for some key levels on the chart. So here's a I don't know, maybe about 2 weeks or so on the chart for Gores, right? And I chose to put my stop at right around 1650, right? The reason why I did that is if we zoom in here, right, we see the series of lows right around 1650, right? The stock bounced off of this price several times, right? And you know, had a cluster of prices right in there. And basically my thesis is that if the stock drops below that, it's going to have more room to fall. And you know, we got it right in this one, because the stock did fall, break below that, and then it fell, you know, another $2. So that's why I put my stop in at 1650. We were able to get out of the stock. You know, we absolutely did miss the bottom. We absolutely didn't pick the top. But again, we still got a very good return on the trade. And that's what's always going to happen if you use stops. There is one caveat, which is you are exposed to pre-market and after-hours risk, right? There could be some crazy movement pre-market or after-hours that could cause you to really miss your stop, and the stock could drop significantly below where you're trying to sell it. But again, I think that risk is okay to take on, given that using this stop strategy to take emotion out of your trades and plan your trades, then allows you to capture upside if the stock continues to have momentum.